For my Lord. Hallelujah. I'm going to ask the sound man to help me just a little bit, having a hard time hearing myself. Hallelujah. God is good. Hallelujah. I'm a witness for the Lord. Thank you, choir. Thank you so much. Let's give the choir a hand. We thank God for being here this evening. We thank God for the program thus far and what we've heard and what we've seen. Hallelujah. Truly, the Lord is in this place. Amen. Amen. God is good. Oh, yes, He is. Hallelujah. He is good. Don't mind me. I'm just waiting on the Lord. See, I don't move till He moves. I can't speak till He speaks. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to give honor to God who is first in my life, who's the head of my life, who's my everything. I thank God that He saw fit to order my footsteps here today, all the way from Rahway, New Jersey, brought me over the airways and brought me here safely, and for that I am thankful. I honor the Lord for your pastor, Pastor Raymond Young. Let's give God a praise for him. God bless you, sir. Come on, y'all can do better than that. Oh, yeah. You ought to thank God for a man of God. Hallelujah. One who loves God and loves the people. Don't ever take your leader for granted. Hallelujah. And we want to thank God for his lovely wife, First Lady Vera Young. God bless you. Amen. And we thank God for his lovely wife. Sometimes we thank God for the pastor, but we forget about his wife. And we don't want to do that as either. Amen? Amen? We thank God for Pastor Dingle and Reverend Walker and to all of the clergy that are here. Hallelujah. To all of the deacons, all of the saints and friends. And I want to thank God for the president of this women's ministry, none other than my mother, Reverend Thelma Perkins. Hallelujah. I love her so much, and God is so good to me because he blessed me with a mother, hallelujah, like none other, and I wouldn't trade her for anything in the world. I love her so much, and it is just a wonder as she stood here and was introducing me. It's just a wonder what God has done and is doing in her life. And I just praise God for it every day. I need you to do something before me before we go into Word. Just do a pew check for me. Y'all know what a pew check is? A pew check is you look down your row and say, this is a praising row. And if you're not a praiser, you're on the wrong row. Come on here. Look down your row. Look down there and make sure that your row is a praising row. Mr. Soundman, they're saying they can't hear me. I can't hear me. I'm gonna need your help. Pray, y'all, pray. Hallelujah. We're going to the word of the Lord, amen? I thank God because the Lord gave me this assignment, and I just want you to know that we're not here by accident, but this appointment is a divine appointment by the will of the Lord. See, because I just don't believe that God brought me all the way from New Jersey just for nothing. But someone in the house needs to hear what God has to say today. And so if you've come today to hear the voice of the Lord and what God has to say, then you're in the right place. We're going to the gospel according to St. Luke chapter 13. We're going to begin reading at verse 10 and go to verse 17. Now, Pastor Young said that I could make myself at home, which is why I had to take off my heels. See, because I had to put my flats on because the Lord already told me I'm on assignment. And when I'm on assignment, I don't need anything to hinder me. So y'all might see me, those of you that know my mom as a preacher, I'm a little different. I might move around a little bit. Is that all right, Pastor Young? All right. St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 13, beginning at verse 10, reading to verse 17. Here beginneth the reading of God's holy word. And he was teaching in one of the synagogues. You may stand. Please forgive me. Stand for the reading of God's word. And he was teaching in one of the synagogues on the Sabbath. And behold, there was a woman which had a spirit of infirmity 18 years. And was bowed together and could in no wise lift up herself. And then Jesus saw her, he called her to him and said unto her, woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity. And he laid hands on her, and immediately she was made straight and glorified God. And the ruler of the synagogue answered with indignation because that Jesus had healed on the Sabbath day and said unto the people, there are 6 days in which men ought to work. In them, therefore, come and be healed and not on the Sabbath day. The Lord then answered him and said, thou hypocrite, doth not each one of you on the Sabbath loose his ox or his ass from the stall and lead him away to watering? And ought not this woman, being a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan hath bound low these 18 years, be loosed from this bond on the Sabbath day? And when he had said these things, all his adversaries were ashamed. And all the people rejoice for all the glorious things that were done by him. So far the scripture. My subject will be taken from that 13th verse, which reads, and he laid his hands on her, and immediately she was made straight and glorified God. Look at someone and say, neighbor, it's time to stand up again. I don't think they got it. Look on the other side and say, neighbor, it's time to stand up again. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. When we read the Bible, before we do that, let's pray. Father, we thank you, Lord God, for this time, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for what you're doing in our midst, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for the word of God. Father, even now, Lord God, I pray that you would hide me behind the cross. Holy Spirit, I welcome you. Holy Spirit, I can't speak without you. Holy Spirit, I can do nothing without you. I pray that you would send the anointing that makes preaching easy. Touch every heart today, oh God. Touch everyone that has come in this building on divine appointment, oh God. Lord God, let your will be done in this house, oh God. And we give you praise and glory. We pray that at the end of this exercise, oh God, sinners would be alarmed, oh God. Lord God, people will be delivered and set free. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. When we read the Bible, we can find many colorful and animated, meaningful characters. We begin to know their names in the Bible as we read, as if they're an old friend of ours. There are many women in the Bible that many of us are familiar with. You know, like Sarah and Rebecca and Elizabeth and Miriam and Mary, the mother of Jesus, to name a few. But there are a handful of women in the Bible who don't show up as big on the radar. In fact, they don't even have names. Though this may suggest that their importance is not as significant as those that have names, I want you to know that they are no less a part of God's story just because they don't have a name. Our text this evening identifies one of these nameless women. She is only referred to as a daughter of Abraham, which suggests she is a woman of faith. In verse 10, we find that Jesus is in the synagogue teaching. In other words, Jesus was in the house of God. According to Luke, this would be the last time that we find Jesus teaching in the synagogue. While he is in the synagogue teaching, a member of the congregation appears on the scene. This member of the congregation is a woman. Look at someone and say, a woman. A woman who had been crippled by a spirit for 18 years. Literally, she had a spirit of infirmity, which is the state of a debilitating illness, sickness, or disease. Luke, the beloved physician, describes her as bent over and could not straighten up at all. The Greek word for this condition is synkupto, which primarily means bent forward, to stoop, to be fixed in a bent position and unable to get back up. Although this sickness was caused by a demonic spirit, let's take a look at the condition medically for a moment. Medically, this disease is probably what physicians today would call spondylitis, a fusion of spinal bones. Spondylitis is a chronic progressive form of arthritis, distinguished by inflammation and stiffness. In some patients, ossification of joints. Treatment focuses on relieving back and joint pain and preventing or correcting spinal deformities. Stay with me, I'm going somewhere. Hallelujah. This condition can cause constant pain, lower back pain, upper back pain, feelings of tiredness when sitting or standing for long periods of time. Sometimes it causes the hips to be uneven and the shoulder to be higher one than the other. Early in the course of this disease, sufferers often find that the pain is relieved somewhat when they lean forward. So they often go through the day leaning slightly forward, trying to relieve the pain. Gradually, their spine begins to fuse. The more they begin to lean forward in order to relieve the pain, the greater the angle becomes. Hallelujah. The patient might be almost doubled over as the woman in our story. So there you see that you have an individual that is dealing with with pain, and they're dealing with so much pain. In order for them to relieve that pain, they keep leaning forward, and every day it gets a little worse, and they say, oh, if I lean a little bit more, the pain won't hurt so bad. I remember growing up, and when I used to come down here to South Carolina to see my grandmother was always bent over like this. And as a young girl, I couldn't understand why she walked like this, and what was it that made her bent over. As I read the text and I remember her having the arthritis, I said, oh, that was the condition that she had. The disease was a progressive disease. The Bible says that this woman was dealing with it for 18 years. But I want you to know that it didn't just happen overnight. She didn't just wake up one day with an 18-year-old problem. But it was 18 years progression where that got her bent over. Hallelujah. I want you to know that some of you have come here tonight and you've been dealing with a situation for a long time. Hallelujah. You've been trying to alleviate the pain, and you've been trying to do what you can to deal with the turmoil. And so what you find yourself doing is compensating for the pain. What is it that you've been dealing with for a long time, and you find that year after year it's getting worse? What debilitating situation did you walk in here with tonight that has you bent over? See, because some of you may not be bent over physically, but you're bent over emotionally. Hallelujah. Everything hurts your feeling. Can nobody say hi to you? Can nobody say how you doing? It's because you're bent over emotionally. Some of you are bent over with depression. Some of you are bent over with regrets. Some of you are bent over with insecurity. Some of you are bent over with fear. And let me tell you what fear does. Fear comes to immobilize you. It comes to keep you stuck in one place. And so the same way that woman was bent over and she could hardly get around, I want you to know that when you get bent over with fear, it's hard for you to move from one place to the other and do what God has called you to do. What is it that has you bent over tonight? Hallelujah. Are you bent over with financial burdens? Can't seem to make ends meet. Are you bent over with the cares of this life and the worrying? You're busy worrying about what's going to happen today and what's going to happen tomorrow. And God, I need you. And God, I need you to do this and do that. Bent over. Some of you have come in here bent over with unbelief, because you don't believe that God can heal you from your situation. But I want you to know that we serve a God who is stronger than any force, who is stronger than any sickness or disease. I've got good news for you. You don't have to stay in that situation. Whatever has you bent over, whatever that pain is you've been dealing with, God says tonight, you don't have to stay in that situation. Hallelujah. The Bible says that she dealt with this situation for 18 years. And what began as lower back pain ended up as a permanent disability. Hallelujah, the Bible says that this sickness was caused by an unclean spirit. So for 18 years, she couldn't
pick herself up. For 18 years, she couldn't look heavenward. For 18 years, all she could do was look down at her feet. Can you imagine what it is to walk like this for 18 years and all you can see is the ground and all you can see is the feet of people coming in and out of your life? Hallelujah. So the Bible says that she was walking bent over for 18 years. And isn't that just like the devil? See, because the devil, he wants to, his ultimate goal is to destroy you. The same way her disease was progressive is the same way the devil deals with us. The Bible says that he comes to steal, kill, and then destroy. See, he ain't going to try to destroy you first. First, he's going to steal from you. Then he's going to kill you. And then he wants to destroy you. His ultimate goal is to keep you looking down. Keep you feeling depressed. Keep you in sickness. Keep you in darkness. Keep you bent over. But look at somebody and say, the devil is a liar. Sometimes you gotta talk back to the devil and let him know that I'm not gonna stay in this condition and I'm not gonna give up and this is not the end of my life. The Bible says that we should look to the hills from whence cometh our help. Our help comes from the Lord. Look at somebody and say, help is on the way. Hallelujah. Let's take a look at what happens. The Bible says that when, in verse 11, and behold, there was a woman which had this spirit of infirmity, 18 years, and was bowed together and in no wise could lift herself up. So she tried to lift herself up. She tried to lift her head, but she couldn't do it because of this spirit of infirmity. And so in verse 12 it says, and when Jesus saw her, see, I can get happy just off of that. I can get happy off of Jesus seeing her. In the midst of him teaching Bible study and in the midst of him preaching in the synagogue, the Bible says that Jesus saw her. Hallelujah. In biblical times, let me tell you something, women. The women could not sit in the same place with the men. But the women were off to the side, sitting off to the side because only the men could be in the main sanctuary. And while Jesus was preaching and teaching, off to the side was this bent over woman. Hallelujah. She didn't even have to be in the main sanctuary. But the Bible says that Jesus saw her where she was. I want you to know it doesn't matter where you are, what station of life you find yourself in. God can see you right where you are. You may be on the back row. Look at somebody, say the back row. Uh-huh. You might be on the front row, but God sees you. Can you imagine this woman making her way to church? This is a woman who had major problems. I'm not talking about some of the stuff we do when we say we ain't going to church. I got a headache. I can't go, Pastor. I stumped my toe. I can't come. The baby got a runny nose. Can't make it to Bible study. No, I'm not talking about that. But I'm talking about a woman who was dealing with a condition for 18 years. And though she dealt with this for 18 years, she found herself in the house of God. She said, I don't care that I can't lift up my head, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to press my way anyhow. I don't don't care that I can't see the preacher, but I can hear what the preacher got to say. I don't care, hallelujah, who speaks to me and who doesn't, but I'm going to make my way to the house of God. And the Bible says that she pressed her way to the house of God. And because she did, the Bible says that Jesus saw her. I want you to know that there's a blessing to come into the house of God. I know in 2015, we don't think it's the thing to do. We got everything else to do. So many distractions. We could have stayed home and watched football. We could have stayed home and watched cable TV. We could have stayed home and watched the Housewives. We could have stayed home and mowed the lawn. We could have stayed home and played with the kids. But is there anybody in here that can say like David, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. In spite of everything she was feeling in her body, racked with pain, she pressed her way. Tired in her body, but she pressed her way. The enemy trying to attack her mind, but she pressed her way. And some of you had to fight to get here tonight. Some of you, we don't know what you went through to get here, but it wasn't easy. Hallelujah. But God said, because you pressed your way, there's a blessing in the house for you. Jesus sees you. Sometimes that's all we need, is for someone to see us. How many times do we come to the house of God and we don't even notice the person sitting right next to us? Sometimes all a person needs is just a simple hello. All they need is a simple, how you doing today? How was your week? Is everything all right? Sometimes you only need to see me, and I feel much better. But the Bible says that although the leader of the synagogue didn't see her, although Sister Sally and Sister May didn't speak to her when she came in, the Bible says that Jesus saw her. And not only did Jesus see her, look what he did next. See, because this is what I love about Jesus. He don't just see you. But the Bible says that when he saw her, he called her. Good God. See, because it's one thing for you to see me, and you see me sitting here in my condition, and you see me, but you don't do nothing. But I want you to know that Jesus didn't leave her like that. Not only did he see her, but he called her. Hallelujah. Aren't you glad that Jesus, when he sees you, hallelujah, not only does he leave you there in that mess, but he's going to call you out. Help me, Holy Ghost. While he's sitting teaching, he calls her forward to the front of the synagogue. I can imagine a hush coming over the sanctuary. Oh, Lord, is Jesus calling Sister Sally all the way from over there? What? I can imagine the whispering. Can you see it? They start whispering. Oh, Jesus called her. Ooh, can you see that? Jesus called her. He called her. And Sister Sally, she's in the back, over there to the side, where the leaders can't notice her or they don't notice her. But Sister Sally is sitting there minding her business, and all of a sudden she hears a voice and says, "Sister Sally, I need you to come to me." Hallelujah. Can you imagine her making her way up to the front where Jesus was? Hallelujah. Looking down at her feet, saying, "Jesus, can this be the day? Jesus, can this be the day that I'm going to get my healing? Can this be the day that I'm going to be set free? I don't know if it is, but Jesus is calling me, and I'm going to come forth." Hallelujah. So she made a way. She made a way to the front, bent over, looking down, depressed, discouraged, but Jesus called her. I want you to know, Jesus is calling you tonight. Woo! Y'all don't believe it because you think I'm just preaching about a woman, but the Lord sent me all the way from Jersey. He said, "Denise, there's some people that I'm going to call tonight, and I'm going to call them out of their sickness. I'm going to call them out of their disease. I'm going to call them out of whatever got them bound." Hallelujah. He called her, and she walked up to the front, and she couldn't see him because she couldn't lift herself up, but she can hear him. Sometimes we can't see God in a situation, but that's why you gotta have the voice of God. You gotta know the voice of God, because the Bible said his sheep know his voice and they follow him. So she made it there to the front, and he called her. And I want you to know, this is a critical point right here I want you to get. The reason why Jesus called her was because he loved her. He didn't call her to make a spectacle of her. He didn't call her to embarrass her, but he called her because he loved her. See, I want you to know that God told me to tell you that Jesus really loves you. Jesus. See, because some of y'all think it's just a cute Bible song story. You know, a song you learn in Sunday school. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. And that's all you know about the love of Jesus. God said, "I'm more than a song." Amen. Look at somebody and say, "He's more than a song." The Bible says that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish. Let me just show you how I know it was an act of love. See, because all throughout scripture, we can see that whenever Jesus saw people in need, he always reached out to help them. In Matthew 14:14, it says, "Jesus went forth and saw a great multitude and was moved with compassion, and he healed their sick." In Mark 1:40-41, it says, "There came a leper to him, beseeching him, 'If you will, you can make me clean.' And Jesus, moved with compassion, put forth his hand and touched him and said, 'I will, be thou clean.'" Jesus went through all the land, healing the sick and casting out demons and setting people free, all because he loves them. I want you to know that Jesus really does love you. I know that you thought that it was like, "Oh, that's just something people say," but he really does love you. So when she arrives, and I'm almost done, when She gets to the front and Jesus calls her. The Bible says that Jesus speaks to the woman. And in verse 12, we see when Jesus saw her, he called her to him and said unto her, "Woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity." I want you to look at the verb loose in Jesus's proclamation. That word loose, it comes from the Greek word apoluo. And this word is used several times in the New Testament. Number one, it's used as a legal term. It means to grant acquittal, to set free and release or pardon. Number two, it means to release from a painful condition. And the third one is that it is a verb in the perfect tense, meaning that it took place in the past, but it continues to take effect today. Woo! So it's something that God already knew was going to happen. He already ordained for that day to come. So it was something that took place in the past, but it continues to take effect today. In other words, you were and you are set free. Look at someone and say, "You were and you are set free." Those of you that have been in prison tonight, I want you to know that God says you are loosed. Those of you that have been locked up in the recesses of your mind, God says you are loosed. Those of you that have been bound with sickness and bound with pain, the Lord said to tell you tonight that you are loosed. Hallelujah. Those of you, hallelujah, that can't seem to make it your way, oh God, can't seem to do anything, God says you are loosed. He said, "Woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity, from thy sicknesses, from thy diseases, from your emotional pain, from your fear, from your hopelessness, from your turmoil, hallelujah, from your thoughts of suicide. I loose you today." The Lord said, there are some of you tonight, you came in bound with invisible chains. Invisible chains. See, I see you all dressed up in your brown and your burnt orange, but beneath the brown and the burnt orange, there's some invisible chains. Oh, yes. And the Lord said that tonight is your night. Tonight is your night to be set free. Tonight is your night to be delivered. Tonight is your night to be loosed. And so the Bible says that when he said, "Woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity," he laid his hands on her and immediately she was made straight. Hallelujah. So let me show you what this looks like. So the Bible says that Jesus calls her and she makes her way to Jesus, all bent over, hallelujah, making her way. And when he lays his hands upon her, the Bible says immediately she stood up. Hallelujah. It didn't take all day and it didn't take all night, but as soon as Jesus laid his hands on her, immediately she stood up again. And I want you to know that God said that it's time for you to stand up again. It's time for you to live life again. It's time for you, hallelujah, to do what God has called you to do. I don't know what you've come in here with, but God said it's time to stand up again. Hallelujah. It's time to give your life to the Lord. It's time to call on Jesus. Hallelujah. He said, "Woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity." And immediately, God, I love that word, immediately. See, because sometimes we think it takes Jesus a long time to do something, but it don't take Jesus a long time. It don't take him a long time to do what he's going to do. Hallelujah. But all you got to do is put your trust in Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Anybody in here want to be set free tonight? Anybody in here want to be loosed? Anybody in here is tired of being bound? Anybody in here want to be set free? I want you to know that it don't take Jesus a long time. It's time for you to stand up again. She was made straight. What she couldn't do for 18 years. One touch with Jesus. Immediately, she stood up. God said, you've been struggling with something for a long time. Good God. Some of you were supposed to go back to school. Some of you were supposed to start a business. Some of you, hallelujah, some of you were supposed to operate in your calling, but because you've been crippled with fear and crippled with doubt and crippled with pain, the Lord says, tonight is your night for you to be set free. I just want to know, is there anybody here that wants to be set free? Because I tell you, God is here. He's just looking for some faith. Oh, yes. And so the Bible says that when he made her straight, when he laid his hands on her, when she had that one encounter with Jesus, hallelujah, that she, her response was one to glorify God. Hallelujah. I want you to know when Jesus sets you free from something, and when you've been dealing with something for a long time, it doesn't matter who's sitting next to you, because you're going to lift your hands and praise God anyway. It doesn't matter who doesn't like you, because you're going to give God the praise anyway. Because you wasn't there when I had to cry at night. You wasn't there when I was in despair. You wasn't there when I thought about committing suicide. You wasn't there when I was counting pennies trying to make ends meet. You wasn't there when I was being ostracized, when I was being looked over. You was not there. And so guess what? I'm going to glorify God. Hallelujah. The Bible says that when Jesus laid hands on her and she was made straight and she glorified God, do y'all know the Bible says that the leader of the synagogue had the nerve to get an attitude? Which lets me know that not everybody is going to be happy with your deliverance. You think that you sit next to somebody that's going to be happy when you get free, but not everybody is happy to see you delivered. See, because they like to see you bound. They like to see you depressed. They like to see you downtrodden. But I want you to know that Jesus is here and he wants to set you free. Jesus called them hypocrites. He said, let me just let you know that tonight, right here at Rock Hill Baptist Church, when I set you free, not everybody is going to be happy, because there's some hypocrites in the midst. Look at somebody and say, are you hypocrite or praiser? Which one are you? Are you the hypocrite or are you the one that's happy for me? Because I want to know. because you, it's not that you want to stop my praise, but I just want to know how hard I need to praise God. See, because if I'm sitting next to the hypocrite, I'm going to praise God even harder because I want to get on your nerves. Hey! Come on and praise him. Hallelujah. Yes. Come on. Come on, musicians. Keep it going. See, because that's the praise I'm talking about. That praise where you don't care what nobody says. Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Tonight, Lord. Touch her in the name of Jesus. Healing even now, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Yes. Release her, Lord. Loose her. Loose her now, Lord. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. You are loose. Loose from your infirmity. Loose in the name of Jesus. Loose. Loose. Yes. Come on, give God praise. Hallelujah. Come on, shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on. Yes. See, I came to give the devil a black eye. I didn't come all the way from Jersey to let this go. But I came to give him a black eye, Pastor Young. And I want you to know, hallelujah, that Jesus has come to set you free. And all you've got to do is give God the praise. Don't worry about who's sitting next to you. Don't worry about who's looking at you. But you've got to give God the praise. Yes! Hallelujah. 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 Oh. Come on and praise him. Hallelujah. Here's what we're going to do next, because we won't give the devil a black eye. Anybody with me tonight? I want to give him a black eye, because he had me bound for a long time. And now that Jesus is setting me free and making me stand up again, I want to let him know that he's the loser. Hallelujah. 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 With the permission of the pastor, I just want to make an altar call. Okay. Because I want those of you that know that you've been bound with something. It may not be a physical disease, but you've been fighting something for a long time. I just want you to make your way to this altar right now. Hallelujah. Because Jesus wants to set you free. Jesus wants to set you free. Jesus wants to set you free. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Jesus is calling you. Jesus is calling you. You don't have to be afraid. You don't have to be worried. Forget about what everybody else thinks. Come on, make your way to the front. Make your way to the front. Oh, Jesus. Come on, come on, come on, come on, he's waiting for you. I'm telling you, he's waiting for you. He's waiting for you. Oh, God. Come on, he's waiting for you. Hallelujah.
Oh, I am.
I want you to grab the hands of your neighbor. Just grab somebody's hand. See, because Jesus is here right now, set you free. Ah, yes. Here. He said, I saw you when you got out your robe. Just take it down a little bit. I saw you when you made your way out your pew. It was an act of faith. Ashata. Hey, shatarabohosa. See, because you could have stayed there. But Jesus said, I saw you. I saw you. I saw you. Make your way to the altar. And because you made your way to the altar, woo! Jesus said, I come to set you free tonight. You've been bent over. But God says, it's time to stand up again. Oh, he's not going to leave you hopeless. He's not going to leave you in that situation. But God says, today, I heal you from that past. I heal you from the brokenness. I heal you from the disappointment. I heal you today. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Uriya, God, you sent me here. You sent me to Rock Hill Baptist Church on September 13th. And you told me that you were ready to loose the people. So God, even now, move upon the people. Break every chain and every fetter. Every invisible chain, Lord, let it be broken even now. Every spirit of infirmity, we cast you out even now. We take authority over you even now. In the name of Jesus, every spirit of depression, we command you to go. In the name of Jesus, everyone that's been locked in the prison of their own minds, we set you free today in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Touch, Lord. Touch and heal. Touch and deliver. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And God, we thank you. We thank you for an immediate blessing. An immediate turnaround. An immediate deliverance. Immediate. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands now. Lift your hands and give God praise. Lift your hands and give God praise. Lift your hands and give God praise. The Lord said it's already done. It's already done. God said he's seen your pain and he's seen your tears and he said it's already done. I loose you from it today. No more disappointment. No more disappointment. I loose you today and I set you free in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Even the work that I called you to do, today I set you free to do it. Set you free to do it. You've been holding back, but God said, give it to me. Give it all to me. All to me today, because I set you free in the name of Jesus. No more chains. No more chains. In the name of Jesus. Hey, God. Yes. Yes. He said, my daughter, my daughter.
Hallelujah. And today I set you free. Today I come to see Taisha in the name of Jesus. And I set you free from every infirmity, from every spirit that holds you down. No more past holding you. In the name of Jesus, go and be who God is calling me. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Come on, clap your hands. Hallelujah. I want you to point your hands towards the pastor. Just take it down a little. Just a little. See, because we're doing warfare right now. We're doing warfare. We're doing warfare. See, because the devil don't want his people to be free. Hallelujah. We're doing warfare. And Father, even now, I humbly lay my hands upon your servant at Shando Santa. And the Nanamasu and the Rabosa. Even now, in the name of Jesus, we pray for a double portion. A double portion of your anointing, oh God. In the name of the Lord Jesus, oh God. Let the spirit of Elijah come upon him, oh God. In the name of the Lord Jesus, oh God. You said in your word, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel, oh God. And God, you've anointed his feet, oh God. God, even now, Lord God, we pray that you would order his footsteps, oh God. Give him, oh God, to walk only through the doors that you have ordained him to walk through, oh God. In the name of the Lord Jesus, oh God. Even now we bind those, oh God, who would try to, Lord God, use his gift, oh God, for gain or for money, oh God. But God, I thank you, Lord God, that he's been separated for you, oh God. Separated for the will of God. Separated to do your will. In the name of Jesus, oh God. God, give him wisdom. Give him wisdom, oh God. Wisdom for the ministry, oh God. In the name of Jesus, give him vision, oh God. Give him, oh God, to know, oh God, who to put in place, who to take out of place. In the name of Jesus. And God, give him a heart that's after your heart. Even as David had a heart after you, give him a heart that after you. In the name of Jesus, bless his ministry. Cause it to overflow. In the name of Jesus. And God, everything that he needs, let it be given unto him. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Receive it now. In Jesus' name. Come on, clap your hands. Clap your hands, clap your hands. I wish I could touch everybody. God, Jesus, hallelujah. Just a simple touch. Just a point of contact. That's what I want to do. Just give you a point of contact to let you know Jesus sees you. He sees you, Karen. Yes, he does. He sees you. He sees you working those two jobs, trying to make ends meet, trying to take care of that son all by yourself. He sees every tear that you cry. He sees you when you wonder, when is it going to be my turn, Lord? When am I going to get what I desire, Lord? I want you to know that he sees you and he cares and he loves you. He said, I have not forgotten you. I did not forget you. Hallelujah. But today, I come to set you free. Today, I come to make your heart glad again. I come to give you joy unspeakable in the name of Jesus. Come on, give God praise. Bless you, mother. Bless you, mother. There's a special anointing on you. There's a special anointing on you, mother. Yes, he said, you're not too old to do what I called you to do. He said, you're not too old to do what I called you to do. That I've put a special anointing on you. People are drawn to you. People love your spirit. He said, just speak my words, mother. Do what I say in
in the name of Jesus. For I have prospered you. I have prospered you. Now go and do the work of the ministry. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Come on, clap your hands. Clap your hands. You're not clapping it for me, because I'm nobody. You're clapping it for Jesus. You're clapping it for Jesus. Only Jesus can set us free. Only Jesus can love us the way we need to be loved. Only Jesus can make an 18-year-old problem go away in one instant. Only Jesus. Only Jesus. Just bask in his presence. We want to make sure the Lord is finished speaking. Just bask in his presence. Ah. Just breathe in, breathe in, breathe in the air of the Lord. See, because sometimes we move too fast. And the Lord is still ministering to somebody. Don't move too fast. Yes, Lord. I know this is different for a lot of you. But I tell you, sometimes God does his best work when we get still before the Lord. The enemy plays with our minds. He says, oh, that word wasn't for you. Go home the same way you left. But we rebuke that in the name of the Lord Jesus. Each and every one of us are going out differently. Look at someone and say, I'm leaving different today. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. And so, Father, we lift our hands and we say thank you. Thank you for the word that you sent in this house, that it is time for us to stand up again. Father, we receive your word. And whatever has had us bound, Lord, we thank you, Lord, that we've been loose tonight. And so we go back out of this place, Lord, standing up tall again, lifting up our heads and doing that which you've called us to do. Father, we love you. Father, we praise you, and we thank you for these blessings. In Jesus' name we pray. Come on, clap your hands for Jesus.